Welcome to Jimmy Bowen and Friends. Each week's episode features Jimmy Bowen and a special guest like Paul Overstreet, Andy Griggs, Jenny Tolman, and more. Today's guest is American Blonde. Now, here's Jimmy Bowen.
An exciting night for you guys. We have some young ladies here, fabulous songwriters and singers. They are going to blow you away with their vocals. I am so excited to have them on the show. We have American Blonde with us tonight, and they're going to be up here with us in just a few minutes, and you guys kind of hang with us, and we'll be right back after these messages.
There's more Jimmy Bowen and Friends coming up right after this.
Award-winning Americana bluegrass red dirt country artist Jimmy Bowen has been creating music and entertaining for over four decades. Jimmy has shared the stage with music greats like William Lee Golden, Linda Davis, Jimmy Fortune, Rhonda Vincent, and more. Jimmy's latest single, Highway, is available through all streaming platforms and digital outlets. For updates on music, upcoming tour dates, and merchandise, head on over to jimmybowen.com.
Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, welcome back to the show. We have got a special guest with us tonight. This is going to be fun. These young ladies are going to blow you away with their vocals and their talent. If you would, make welcome American Blonde.
Going?
This is going to be exciting. I saw you guys during rehearsal, and it was amazing.
Thank you. We are so honored to be here, man. Thank you for having us.
Oh, this is going to be fun. Let's give them a little bit of history here, okay?
All right.
You guys were raised up around the Mississippi Delta.
That's right.
Okay, there you go. So what enticed you guys to want to do it professionally together?
Oh, man.
Well, we were really little girls. I think we were about like around the ages of 9 and 10.
That's right.
And not a whole lot to do in the Delta. So we actually gravitated towards music really quickly. You know, that is the birthplace of all American music.
That's right, the blues, baby.
B.B. King and Robert Johnson, not too far away from we lived. And so, yeah, we wanted to be just like the blues singers and songwriters back in the day. Obviously, we've changed a little bit.
Just a little.
little country twist.
Well, that's great. Now, you guys did something that absolutely kind of changed your life, didn't you? You entered the Texaco County Showdown?
Yes,
that's
the right. Texaco Country Showdown.
That's right. Wow, what a wild experience.
I did. I was like, oh, my goodness, how many years ago
was
that?
Over it. We little babies.
Little babies.
Yeah, we actually entered in because we were playing blues for a hot minute there, and we had the one weekend where we did not have a blues gig.
Yeah.
And we saw in Greenville, Mississippi, they were doing a little tryout for the Texaco Country Showdown.
We were like, we don't know what this is or what it's going to end up as, but we're just going to do it, try it out, and have some fun, you know?
Yeah.
Why not? Music is always fun, so we're going to partake.
And we did, and we showed up, and we played one of our favorite covers growing up harmonically, and it was a hit. And so long story short, we ended up making it to the regionals and the finals.
That's
and
right.
We got to come to Nashville, Tennessee for the first time, and it was aired on the Ryman Auditorium stage, which was really cool.
Which was crazy. It's like our first taste of the country music world in Nashville.
Yeah.
We're like, wow, we love this city.
And
we
love
these people. Like,
and
what a cool
fun
thing.
Little fact. We ended up, I wrote my first song ever because you can get bonus points if you had an original song for
that's
the competition.
Right. She's like, I'm doing that.
And it was about cowboys. But that's a story for
Go
another
figure.
Time.
Now, with y'all doing all that and moving forward with your careers, you've probably had some really neat experiences, some memorable artists that you've gotten to be around, perform with. Talk a little bit about that. Who
man.
You got to be around and play with?
Man, it's crazy. We've been playing music together since we were really little. And then after the Texaco, we had the awesome opportunity to meet Mr. Jeff Cook from the band Alabama.
That's right.
And
yeah.
He took us under his wing and taught us how to record our very first EP.
I mean, he brought us to his home in Alabama, and we were like, what is going on? This is amazing. He saw us on the Texaco Country Showdown, and that's how he ended up, like, gravitating towards us and being like, I want to teach them everything there is to know about the music industry. And it was just
cool.
So cool, man. That's pretty much how we got our start here.
Yeah. And then it would actually, so that kind of just gravitated towards opening up for a lot of acts like, oh my goodness, Brantley Gilbert, Maren Morris, Parmalee, Uncle Cracker, Old Dominion.
Yeah. Maren Morris, yeah, you already said that.
Lee Bryce.
Lee Bryce.
And, Billy Currington, so many amazing people who have actually taught us a lot as we went.
Music's been good to us, so we love it.
Well, that's great. Tell us about, now you're going to do this tonight, but tell us about the song Dust on My Wings.
Oh, this one's a special one.
Did y'all write
that, co-write it? Natalia did. She co-wrote that with a friend of hers.
Yeah, Miss Jordan Rayner. She was actually on The Voice this season, if you guys were watching that, and she's been killing it out there. And so I got together with Miss Jordan Rayner, and if you know her, she is a rebel just like this one. She's the drummer. You'll
see
later. I was like, I want to write about these rebel kids, and she was the perfect person to help me write this song. Our grandfather was actually in the hospital at the time, and he was the one who kind of inspired me that wanted to play the guitar, really. And he wasn't doing well, and I was just telling her about, like, you know, he was kind of an edgy guy. Like, do you think he'll go to heaven? And she's like, oh, he'll just have a little dust on his wings. And that's exactly why we wrote the song.
It clicked.
Yeah. You're going to do it right now.
We sure will.
You guys
We'd
put
love
your hands
to.
Together for American Blonde.
Thank y'all.
I was born with a fire in my eyes. Trouble knew my name before my mama did. And I've ripped and torn, bearing my way through this life. I've stretched a thousand second chances end to end. Don't get me wrong, this sinner's seen the light, and I've got a road. It just won't be right, 'cause nobody lives forever. So I'll live forever young. I might be raised in hell down here when the call of heaven comes. I'm rolling like an outlaw, jumping off a runaway train. I won't be the only angel dust on my wings. I jokes. It'll be enough for me to have a halo at all. I won't be first at the table, but I'll be above my own. Nobody lives forever, so I'll live forever young. I might be raising hell down here when the call to heaven comes. Rolling like an outlaw, jumping off a runaway train. I won't be the only angel. Dust on my wings. Jesus, save the sinners. He's no stranger to my kind. He may smile and shake his head, but he won't be surprised. Nobody lives forever, so I'll live forever young. I might be raising hell down here when the call to heaven comes. I'm rolling like an outlaw, jumping off a runaway train. I won't be the only angel.
Don't go away. Jimmy Bowen and friends will be right back.
Award-winning Americana bluegrass red dirt country artist Jimmy Bowen has been creating music and entertaining for over four decades. Jimmy has shared the stage with music greats like William Lee Golden, Linda Davis, Jimmy Fortune, Rhonda Vincent, and more. Jimmy's latest single, Highway, is available through all streaming platforms and digital outlets. For updates on music, upcoming tour dates, and merchandise, head on over to jimmybowen.com.
Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
That was awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I love y'all's vocals. This is just amazing.
Thank you. We love doing vocals together.
It's really amazing. Well, the sibling thing helps a lot, though, probably.
I'm sure it does.
It does. I have to say, I love having Tinka out front, too. She's always behind me on the drums,
that's
so
right.
That was really nice.
They always put me in the cage in the back.
You're over there all the time.
Well, you got to tame me somehow.
Well, this next question I have for you is, it's always intriguing to me because I'm not a writer, and it's always amazing to me how writers come up with ideas and things like that. So what is it that you guys love most about writing?
Well, I've tried writing, and it didn't go very well. So I'm going to let you answer that question.
Well, I feel like it keeps going back to expressing yourself. You know, we all, no matter what age we are or where we are in our lives, we all get to experience so many different things at so many different times. And sometimes, you know, I feel like that really comes together as one thing, and it's really nice to be a songwriter to be able to write how you feel and hope that you can put it out
Absolutely.
There and feel that other people feel the same way.
Yeah.
And when you have people sing your songs back, you're like, oh, I'm not alone.
It's really cool, too. You get to build a community based on the songs that you write as well.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's how you really find your people in life, because you know that they're feeling exactly what you're feeling and, you know, vice versa. And I just love that.
Yeah.
How with you guys, with your age and where you are, your status with your career right now, and I have my own feelings on it too, but we're living in a real different world right now.
Yes.
So how is social media, how has that affected you guys? And what is, you know, from a young artist perspective, what's going on with social media with you guys?
Ooh, it's a broad topic. I love that social media is able to really let us connect to new people around the world. You know, social media is the reason why we got to tour Canada and Europe and, you know, meet new radio DJs and people like us, you know, who didn't go to college or didn't get to, you know, go into like having a degree or anything. You just wanted to jump into the music industry and see what that's all about.
Yeah.
So I love that social media connects us with that. But of course, you know, being in this day and age where we're growing with social media as well, it's really good for us to have each other and kind of take a step back and a breather and get out of the phone and like really enjoy every single moment of life.
Yep.
That's the tricky part.
Okay. Now, do you guys have any new music coming out this year?
We do. We have so many new songs that we are releasing in 2024. And we're actually going to be playing this next song. It's going to be the one that is released right now. So we're excited about that.
And this is the new song, right?
This is a new song.
You look better on the way out.
You do.
Okay, this is going to be cool. I'm going to dig this. You guys put your hands together and make welcome again American Blonde.
Back with more Jimmy Bowen and Friends in just a moment.
Award-winning Americana bluegrass red dirt country artist Jimmy Bowen has been creating music and entertaining for over four decades. Jimmy has shared the stage with music greats like William Lee Golden, Linda Davis, Jimmy Fortune, Rhonda Vincent, and more. Jimmy's latest single, Highway, is available through all streaming platforms and digital outlets. For updates on music, upcoming tour dates, and merchandise, head on over to jimmybowen.com.
welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, welcome back. What did you think of American Blonde? Yeah. Very talented young lady, great songwriters and singers. They have got a bright future ahead of them, that's for sure. We're going to say goodnight to you guys on this song. This song was written by a good friend of ours, Craig Market, and comes from a bluegrass background, and so do I. And we just kind of like this song. And Steve Cummings, the drummer, loves this too because it's got a banjo in it. So Steve's a big fan of banjo. So he's got all Earl Scruggs albums. Anyway, we're going to say goodnight to you guys, and we'll catch you on the next show.
Sitting on the back porch, my head in my hand, and I'm trying to understand. Except the one, she don't think love this man. Her eyes shine like diamonds, her hair's black as coal. When she smiles, I get weak in the knees. I'm in love with an angel, no one disagrees. But this angel, she ain't in love with me. If I spend another night without sleeping, when I place the gold ring on her hand. But her gaze towards another brought rage in my heart. Now she's sleeping in peace beneath the sand. Well, I'm locked in a small room with time on my hand, and I'm trying to understand how my love for an angel could cause so much pain, misery for this broken man. If I spend another night without sleeping, I think I'm growing insane. The love that sustained me has faded away. My tears